What is up, guys? This is Chris Miner, and today we are playing Fallout 4. This is episode 13 of Let's Play Fallout 4. Last episode, we did some missions to get Liberty Prime back online, did some fetch missions to go retrieve some items for Proctor Ingram, and I think this is the last one. Liberty Prime's about to come back and destroy the Institute for good.
Like you've been through the ringer, Paladin. Can't say that I blame you. That was a hell of a business with Dance. Can't even imagine having to look him in the face and pull the trigger.
If we're gonna defeat the Institute, we can't allow personal feelings to interfere with our mission.
Spoken like a true disciple of Maxon. Anyway, we need to move on to more important things now. Like getting Liberty Prime off of life support. We've been feeding him power through the Pridwin's engines, but there isn't nearly enough juice to cold start his fusion reactor. That's why we need you to find us a beryllium agitator.
Beryllium agitator.
And I'm betting you know right where to find it.
Of course I do. I didn't become head of ship maintenance just because of my good looks, you know. Quinlan dug up some dirt on a company called Mass Fusion. They were a power utility company before the world went belly up. The CEO was some kind of an inventor. Dreamed up all sorts of nuclear power toys. The agitator was his crown jewel. Records show he was working on it in his lab at the top of their high-rise in the financial district. That's where we're headed. Hope you don't mind a little company, because I'm coming with you.
It would be helpful if you tagged along.
I knew you'd see it my way. Kells has a vertibird on standby, waiting to drop us off on the roof of the Mass Fusion Tower. Grab whatever gear you need and meet me on the flight deck. But don't take too long. If the Institute finds out the agitator's there, they'll do everything they can to keep it out of our hands.
Fly to Mass Fusion.
Can't talk right now. Gotta clean the Mirelux scat off my boots.
I wasn't even trying to talk to you. We can go, right? Oh, we need to wait for this. Get on! Finally.
Roger that, Scabbard. We have clearance for release. You might want to hang on, sir. The drop can be a little rough. Never could get used to flying in these things.
Drop.
Not lowering my weapon, fool. It's for the greater good.
Security's too good.
Calm down, Noel. You knew that this was coming. I don't understand why you're acting this way. Don't tell me to calm down, Carl. When we started designing the Beryllium Agitator, you said it would be for the benefit of mankind. Instead, I find out that you've been planning on turning it over to the military all along. You lied to me.
Dr. Ingram.
I can't believe it. Since when did science start taking sides?
Like it or not, when the testing cycle is completed, I'm crating up the agitator and sending it off to Washington. Now, you have two choices. Either you can get back to work, or you can get the hell out of my building.
Building's a mess. I hope the agitator's still here.
Can't break the code. There we go.
The password is Twinkie.
Down.
Probably not.
Detected. Curious.
Been years looking at the tech in this place, but we've still got work to do.
There it is.
Mass fusion's reactor. Don't make them like that anymore.
How about we grab this thing before our team starts falling out?
That would be a good idea.
Radiation levels are dangerously high in there. Let me know if you need any radiation protection. I'll communicate with you through their intercom system while I monitor everything from out here.
Please wait. Complete. You may proceed.
same agitator should be in a port at the top of the reactor. Keep moving.
Thank you.
Liberty Prime's about finished. Return to Boston Airport.
I have some important work to do. Excuse me,
Proctor Ingram.
Glad to see you're still in one piece.
I wouldn't have made it without your help.
That's funny. I seem to remember having to talk you into letting me come along. Anyway, we shouldn't stand around here talking. We've got a lot of work to do. Well, this is it. The moment of truth. We pre-programmed Liberty Prime's battle coordinates into its navigational processor. As soon as he's under his own power, he'll head straight for the Institute. Elder Maxson wants you to follow, and make sure he arrives at the CIT in one piece. I've checked every wire and every bolt on the big guy. All we need to do is plug in the agitator, start Prime's reactor, and cross our fingers.
This is going to be a short war if Prime can't move.
You aren't kidding. Look, I discussed it with Elder Maxson. And we think you should be the one who has the honor of starting Liberty Prime. Just plug the beryllium agitator into his reactor port, then head back down here and press the transfer button. Good luck, Paladin. Ad Victorium.
Ad Victorium.
Look, I'm really busy, and I'm not in the mood for talking.
I'm not even talking to you. I will shoot you. The moment of truth. Will Liberty Prime work? Oh, everyone is gathering here. Already was used in the Battle of Anchorage and in 2277 for the Battle of the Capital Wasteland. Time to start him up and blow
we
up.
We really should just stay out of each other's way.
I'm not talking to you! And blow up the synths.
Fusion core reinitialized. Liberty Prime, full system analysis. All systems nominal. Weapons hot. Mission: the destruction of any and all Chinese communists. Probability of Chinese victory impossible.
Brotherhood, salute. Ad Victorium.
Proceeding to target coordinates. Freedom is the sovereign right of every American. Democracy is non-negotiable. The sovereign rights of every American.
Who's there?
Liberty
static defenses.
This is it, the Institute.
Obstruction.
Just dropped a nuke inside of a hole. We're back. Elder Maxson.
Don't worry.
Has a Gatling laser.
The mission is proceeding as planned, Paladin. Well done.
Where's your target is the reactor. Power
arm. If anything tries to slow us down, I'm ordering you to destroy it. Man or machine. Once we reach our target, you'll need this. It's a fusion pulse charge. Attach it to the reactor, and it can be detonated remotely from a safe distance. It will be more than enough to annihilate the Institute in its entirety. Ingram, you're to remain here and teleport us out when the job is done. Get that thing working.
This is a real mini nuke fusion pulse charge. This isn't the Institute. This is the old part of the Institute.
Someone present. Movement detected. You must.
Institute Bioscience. They let out the gorillas.
Expect to see you again. Come to see the reactor, have you? We got it working without you.
I'm sorry it's come to this, Sean.
You're sorry? You can't be that sorry if you're here going through with it.
Yeah.
It's not enough that I lay here dying. Now you plan on what? Destroying everything? Tell me then. Under what righteous pretense have you justified this atrocity?
All the enemies you've created? You can't imagine why I'd be standing here?
Perhaps I didn't think to count you among them. Well, none of it matters now, I suppose. You'll accomplish your task and ruin humanity's best hope for the future. The only question left then is why you're standing here. Is it regret? Or did you just come to gloat?
Sean, if you help me, fewer people will die. Will you?
Why would I ever consider helping you?
Help me, and we can try and minimize the casualties in all this. You want your people to survive, don't you?
Very well. The terminal behind me. Enter access code 9003. That will disable some of the synths. Now go. Just leave me.
Sean.
You've doomed humanity. You know that? there's nothing more to say.
Sean, I'm sorry that it's come to this.
It's too late to be sorry. There we go.
Well done, Paladin. Looks like a path should be clear to the reactor. And I am happy to report that reinforcements have arrived.
Something's out there. Thank you.
blow this place back to hell.
In and out, Paladin. We make this fast and precise. Good work, Paladin. I think it's time to leave this place to its fate. Proctor Ingram, do you copy? Our mission is complete. I need you to transport us out of here immediately.
Always on good behavior, are you?
Dr. Ingram, it's time to teleport us out.
Sorry, Elder, I would, but, well, this child showed up. He claims to be the Paladin's son, sir.
Authorization 1Y.
Please, Dad, don't leave me here. I want to go with you.
Please proceed to your assigned evacuation point. Thank you for your cooperation.
All right. You can come with me.
Really? Do you mean it?
Yes, I mean it. Now, let's get out of here.
I'm glad you were here to save me.
I've got this covered, Paladin. Get to that reactor.
Evacuation order issued.
All right, Ingram. Fire it up.
Everything looks green. System's warmed up and ready to go if you are.
Absolutely. Let's get out of here.
You got it, Paladin. I'm going to send you and Elder Maxon directly to the detonation site. I'll make sure the kid gets some new clothes and reaches the airport safely. When that reactor goes up, this place will be nothing but a smoking crater full of rubble. Should be quite a sight. Looks like your work here is done, Paladin.
Evacuation order issued. Authorization.
I'm ready. Let's get out of here.
Press that button, and you not only defeat our enemy, you restore order and decency to the Commonwealth. It's time, Paladin. The Institute and their synth abominations must be eradicated.
So this is the end of the Institute for good. Maybe the Commonwealth will be saved. Maybe this was a mistake. But we can't go back now. We chose to go with the Brotherhood, and with the Brotherhood, we will be. Institute, goodbye. Sean, aka Father, goodbye.
I can feel it wash over me. The heat, the force, the radiation, the fear. It's the end of the world, all over again. I close my eyes. I see my life before all of this, before the bombs. Everything can change in an instant, and the future you plan for yourself shifts, whether or not you're ready. At some point, it happens to all of us. This wasn't the world I wanted, but it was the one I found myself in. The Commonwealth. My home. Ripped apart and put back together. I thought, I hoped, I could find my family, cheat time, make us whole again. The way we were. But I know I can't go back. I know the world has changed. But the road ahead will be hard. This time, I'm ready. Because I know war. War never changes. Elder.
You've done an exemplary job here, Paladin. Without your unwavering loyalty to our cause, this victory would never have been possible.
I did it for the people of the Commonwealth.
You truly have become one of us, brother. The Institute has been wiped clean from the face of our world. It's time we close this chapter on the Commonwealth and begin one anew.
What do you mean, Elder?
It means we still have a long road ahead if we're to ensure the safety of the Commonwealth and her people. But this is neither the time nor the place to discuss it. Return to the Pridwin, and we'll decide what needs to be done.
We're getting a 3% seed tilt.
Paladin, I'm pleased you've returned. Captain Kells and I wanted to speak with you. Captain Kells.
As I expect Elder Maxson has already explained, the destruction of the Institute is simply the first stage of our operations in the Commonwealth. There are still super mutants and ferals to be dealt with, as well as any remaining synths that escaped the blast. It's our hope that you will continue serving with the Brotherhood and assist us with eradicating these threats.
I think I've had enough fighting.
The campaign has taken its toll on all of us, Paladin. I understand your hesitation. There's no need for your new duties to commence immediately. Take your time, and when you're ready, there will be plenty of missions to undertake.
In light of your service, Captain Kells and I both feel you deserve unique recognition for your contributions, both past and future. It's with great pleasure and the utmost respect that you are hereby granted the title of Sentinel. This is the highest honor a Brotherhood soldier can achieve. But we both felt strongly that it was well deserved.
In addition, we'd like to present you with this jetpack modification for your power armor. The Brotherhood has few of these devices in its possession, but we feel you've earned the right to utilize one of them. Congratulations, Sentinel. It's an honor to be serving with you.
Would I be the only Sentinel in the Brotherhood?
In our division? Yes. There hasn't been a Sentinel serving under me for many years now. It's a position that commands a great deal of honor and respect, so I do not award it lightly.
Thank you, both. I'm really quite honored.
The honor is ours. So, Sentinel, for the first time since we've met, I have no orders for you. From this moment forward, you will decide which missions you undertake and how you will guide us. Captain Kells and the personnel of the Cambridge Police Station still possess numerous operations for you to undertake. Where you go from here is up to you. Ad victorium, Sentinel.
Pinging remote units at 30-second intervals as requested.
All right, guys. That is the end of episode 13 of Let's Play Fallout 4. I'm pretty sure this might be the last episode in terms of the main story being completed. I will most definitely make other videos for, like, the DLCs, because I own all of the DLCs. Might make some videos on some mods. That would probably have to be done on my Xbox, because you can't get very good mods on PlayStation Fallout. But, yeah. Might do settlement building, other quests. But definitely expect the next video to maybe just be a follow-up to this. Show off my settlements and what's happened. And after that, or the next episode might be a DLC episode, because I have the whole season pass. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe.